Our team 30 worked on the project Foraminifera species identification using convolutional neural networks. We picked this project because planktonic foraminiferal species identification is central to many paleoceanographic studies. The species identification from the images requires domain expertise. With the advent of neural networks for visual recognition, human-level accuracy is being achieved in various visual recognition tasks. The fine-grained image classification task focuses on differentiating between hard-to-distinguish object classes such as species of birds, flowers, or animals, and in our case, foraminiferal species identification. This type of classification is challenging because it is difficult to identify between species as they have subtle differences and complicated discriminating features. We're using the dataset of foraminiferal species images collected from Endless Forams portal. Planktonic foraminifera are marine mixotropic protists that are widely used to reconstruct past oceans and climates. Due to the abundant fossil record of their calcite test throughout much of the world's ocean, they're also a focal taxa for studies of biology, ecology, and evolution for the same reason. The dataset consists of 27,729 foraminifera images of 35 species. You can see some of the images from the four species that were in the dataset here. As we encountered class imbalance in our dataset, which can be seen in the graph, we used stratified sampling to generate a validation set from the acquired dataset. The validation set has 10% of the total data, and the rest of the data is used for training our model. Initially, we implemented VGG16 as we found that it gives the best validation accuracy for our dataset in the template paper for our baseline model. The VGG model investigates the depth of layers with a very small convolution filter size 3x3 to deal with large scale images. VGG16 is composed of 13 convolution layers, 5 max pooling layers, and 3 fully connected layers. We refer to the model used in the template paper and implemented VGG16 by freezing the first 7 layers and using a learning rate of 0.0001 with Adam optimizer and categorical cross entropy as a loss function. As we encounter a class imbalance, we tackle that by feeding weights for each class to the model, which modifies our model to handle classes with less observations. The class weights are generated based on frequency of each class. We further fine-tune the model by running models for 5 more epochs by increasing the frozen layers to 13 and reducing the learning rate by a factor of 10. We got a validation accuracy of 0.85, which is close to the accuracy that was reported by the baseline template paper. Difference in the accuracies could have arisen because of the different training data that could have been used by the paper. We used a bilinear CNN with 2 VGG16 networks. The intuition behind the bilinear CNNs can be understood as a simple parallel CNNs, each trying to identify different features of the same image. Simple parallel CNNs are combined using matrix outer product, and the outputs from CNNs are taken before the fully connected layers. We use bilinear CNN because it overcomes some of the problems of linear CNN, such as improvement in fine-grained classification. The 2 VGG16 networks used in bilinear CNN use the same parameters as the baseline model. We got a validation accuracy of 0.86, which shows that our model performs better than the baseline model as expected and increases the accuracy by 1%. To increase the accuracy further, we implemented exception model on our dataset. Exception is a convolution neural network architecture based entirely on the depth-wise separable convolution layers. Exception architecture has 36 convolution layers that are structured into 14 modules, all of which have linear residual connections around them, except for the first and last modules. We implemented exception with no frozen layers and using a learning rate of 0.001 with Adam optimizer and categorical cross entropy as the loss function. We achieved a validation accuracy of 0.89 with this model. This model performs better because it is able to capture different features from distinct sizes of the convolution filters, which is a crucial part for fine-grained image classification. As we saw, the bilinear model increases the accuracy of a CNN-based architecture. So we implemented a bilinear CNN model with 2 exception networks. The 2 exception networks used in the bilinear CNN use the same parameters as the previous model. We achieved a validation accuracy of 0.9 with this model. The model performs better than the previous model as expected. We achieved the best accuracy of 0.9 with bilinear CNN exception-based model. The best accuracy we achieved beats the accuracy mentioned in the template paper. Thank you.